All right, joining us now on Hot Copy for the latest on the government's COVID-19 response, we have Cabinet Secretary Karlo Nograles. Secretary Nograles, good morning to you.
Magandang umaga sa iyo, Karen, at good morning sa lahat ng mga nakikinig at nanonood ngayon.
All right, let's start with the government studying the possibility of scrapping quarantine classifications. Ano exactly ang pinag-uusapan?
Well, right now, that's just to clear the air, no? That's not going to happen anytime soon. That's only something that we are considering after we are able to inoculate 50 million to 70 million Filipinos. So that's just for future, no, reference. Yan po ay pinag-uusapan in the context of after we achieve population protection, or what some people loosely call as herd immunity. That's the only time when we can talk about giving the quarantine classifications to LGUs. So right now, it is still the same protocols, which is ang quarantine classifications will be given by the national IATF as recommendations to the president, and the president ultimately will make the final decision as to what community quarantine classifications we will be imposing per month on different regions, provinces, pati mga localities.
Okay, that's good you made that clarification, Secretary Nograles. So this is not happening soon, but what is the condition for this to happen? You said if we achieve population protection or herd immunity. And Secretary Roque and other experts have said that's very different. Herd immunity is 70% of the population, and population protection exactly is, am I right to say they defined it as just covering A1 to A3?
No, yung sa amin naman kasi, yung population control happens when certain populations or certain areas are already medyo protected na. We are comfortable in the level of the population.
So this having, is 50%?
Yes, roughly ganon, no? Siguro, ibigyan na natin ng context, no? We always say 50 to 70 million Filipinos vaccinated by December of 2021. And the reason we have a wide range na 50 million to 70 million is because ang factor dyan is supply and demand. We can guarantee that we will have enough supply for that, no? For 70 million Filipinos by December 2021. But of course, it will also depend on the uptake at kung gaano karami kalawak at karami ang ating mga kababayan who will actually agree to be vaccinated. And that's really the demand factor there. Kaya while we're procuring enough supplies, as you reported kanina, 40 million from Pfizer is the latest, no? Solidified supply agreement. We continue to drive demand, or at least convince more and more of our population, of our Filipino people, to accept and take the vaccines as they come along. And we're ready to deploy. As soon as they come in, we deploy to the LGUs, and the LGUs now will start administering it. But if you go by the one-third results ng survey, one-third ang convincido, one-third will not so convinced yet, no? And one-third are medyo refuse, no? So we need to cover as much ground as possible, and we need to convince as many people as possible to take the vaccines. So okay. Continuous yung rollout natin to cover everything. But again, the 50 to 70 million, kasi may low and my high range tayo depending on the demand, no, that we're able to generate at the end of the day.
Okay, the 40 million Pfizer vaccines, which is a solidified agreement, what is the timetable or the schedule for its arrival? I'm presuming hindi ito 40 million doses in one shipping. No. Or is it in one shipping? Okay.
It will come in tranches. So basically, the Pfizer vaccines that we're receiving, that we've been receiving, are through the COVAX facility, no, ng WHO. This one is different. in the sense that this one is actually the ones that are procured, no, by government. So ang indicative timeline nito, according to Secretary Galvez, is that perhaps by July, late July, or maybe August, it will start coming in, and it will be in tranches. And this is in accordance rin with our timeline, because we've actually already said, no, that while we have the most number of doses now in June compared to previous months, we will have even more doses coming in July. But then in August, ito po yung August, September, October, November, leading to December. This will be the months that we will have just so many vaccines coming in all at the same time.
Mm-mm. So technically 40 million doses is for 20 million Filipinos, tama? Yes. Because it's covering two doses per Filipino. Yes. If it is coming in July, itong 40 million ang Pfizer is coming in within the year, Secretary?
Yes, within the year yan. So July or maybe August, mas sure yata yung August or late July. So something like that, late July to August. Then siguro ma-imagine natin 40 million divided by, I don't know, maybe within the next 4 or 5 months.
And is it right to say with the 40 million doses of Pfizer, this more than 50% is now going to Visayas and Mindanao?
Would yung Pfizer, maselan yung Pfizer, ha? So that's the most sensitive in terms of the ultra-cold storage that's needed. So necessarily, yung Pfizer has to go to areas where there is a capability ng LGU to store it at negative 70, negative 80.
Mm-mm.
So only LGUs na merong ganyang klaseng capacity or facility will be the ones to be given or kung saan namin pwede i-deploy ang Pfizer.
Oo. So most likely in big cities. I'm curious, ang Davao City ba has a cold storage?
Yes. So Davao, okay. Cebu. Of course, Metro Manila.
Of course.
I think Cagayan de Oro also has, Bataan also has, and several other LGUs that have actually prepared. And they've invested, no, or they have the facilities for ultra-cold storage.
Uh-oh. Because Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, I'm sure you're familiar, he snapped back last week and he said Mindanao was being neglected, and now you have Iloilo City Mayor Trenas appealing for more vaccines also and equipment. He says only 1.8% have been vaccinated in Iloilo. What is the solution for LGUs like Iloilo, for example? Hindi ba pwede yun mapadala na ng Sinovac? I know there's still Sinovac, may inventory pa in Manila.
Yes, the latest instruction ni Pangulo, di ba, is that those areas na mataas ang bilang ng COVID will have to get the an increased number of vaccines, no? Parang nilike niya yan to a situation na may sunog, di ba? So all firefighters will have to concentrate, no, on the area kung saan may biggest case ng sunog, no? Kumbaga, so i-concentrate doon. So in the same manner, pagdating sa COVID, ganun din. So tingnan natin kung saan yung mga MECQ areas, and that includes Iloilo, that includes Cagayan de Oro, no, that includes the other areas na naka-MECQ dahil mataas nga ang bilang ng COVID-19. Doon tayo magko-concentrate ng vaccines. Tamang-tama, parating naman yung mga additional doses ng vaccines. So while we maintain the same level of vaccine deployment dun sa mga iba't ibang areas and municipalities, which is about, depende sa size ng municipality, it's about 100 to 200 vaccine doses per municipality depending on their size per deployment. While maintaining that, the new additional vaccines we can deploy to areas na mataas ang bilang ng COVID. So while the other LGUs are consistently getting their usual number of doses, the areas na mataas ang bilang ng COVID will get additional doses according in accordance with the directive of the president.
Uh-oh. Do you have any idea the range of how much we are paying for Pfizer? I know this is, of course, coming from the Asian Development Bank, but is there a range? This is in terms of a loan, a range of how much we're spending to procure Pfizer?
Pasensya na, Karen, I can't speak about the prices, no. And that would be something na siguro mas pwede pang masabi ni either ni Secretary Galvez or Secretary Dominguez.
Okay. Now, the policy in terms of a fully vaccinated Filipinos returning to the country. Let's talk about this. Right now, the policy of the DOH is COVID-19 testing is exempted if a Filipino who was vaccinated in the Philippines traveled and then went back. That's the exemption. Tama yun, Secretary?
Yes, for... Liwanagin ko lang, no, we're not biased or prejudiced or creating any about classifications, undue classifications about Filipinos who are vaccinated here versus Filipinos vaccinated abroad, no. That's not the issue. The issue lang naman here is how do you verify and authenticate that they've actually been fully vaccinated. Dito sa bansang Pilipinas, sa Philippines, it's easy for us to authenticate and verify. Diba? Kasi madali lang naman to verify with our LGUs kung totoo ngang vaccinated na to. Apart, of course, from the list that sinasabit ng LGU sa amin, sa national, it's easy for us to verify with the LGU themselves kung totoo nga vaccinated na si Juan de la Cruz. Ang problema namin ngayon is how do we authenticate si Pedro de la Cruz if he was truly vaccinated in the States or in Europe or in the Middle East. Wala pa yung procedure na yan. Yun lang po yung pinaka-issue. That being said, we've already assigned that to a small group in the IATF, led of course by the Department of Foreign Affairs, no, and other members of the IATF. They were supposed to report to us nung Thursday, the last IATF meeting. But because hindi pa na-solidify yung protocol or yung verification process, they asked for more time. Mm-hmm. And then so we gave them more time over the weekend. And we hope that they will be able to report to us already sometime this week about anong klaseng procedure, no, ang pwedeng gawin ng ating Bureau of Immigration and Bureau of Quarantine, for instance, to verify that indeed si Pedro de la Cruz was really fully vaccinated, no. Anong klaseng proof or evidence ang kinakailangan niya at anong kailangan niyang gawin bago pa man siya pumunta ng Pilipinas to have some documents ready so that pag landing niya sa bansa, mapakita niya yung documents, then it's easy for our immigration officials or quarantine officials to say, okay, yes, you're fully vaccinated. So the same procedure or will apply sa'yo, which is the 7 days without testing necessary.
Okay. It doesn't really sound too complicated. I wanted to ask you, can't a Filipino, for example, once they get vaccinated, let's say, I don't know, anywhere, no, Europe, yeah, Middle East, or the U.S., before traveling back, of course, they don't have vaccination passports yet abroad, but can, let's say, I don't know, the embassy, the consul, give a stamp in the passport of some kind to say this is a fully vaccinated OFW or even a balikbayan?
Yeah, that's one of the, that's one of the options that we're looking at, no? But at the same time, we have to understand na ayaw rin po natin na the embassy will be, you know, full to the brim with many, yes, people. So there has to be several options. You can't just have that one option na go to the embassy, get your, diba? So it has to be plenty of options, and we have to define the procedure so that we don't make it unnecessarily difficult also, no, for them, especially areas na walang embassy or malayo yung embassy sa kanya, di ba? Is there a way, another way? So yun ang fina-finalize lang po natin. So hindi rin mahirap. Because if you say embassy or consulate, then what about Filipinos na wala namang embassy consulate or malayo sila, di ba? They'll have to travel. So mm-hmm. that will make it even more tedious for them.
Okay. I'm curious, what kind of proof are you seeing, Secretary Nograles, that Malikbayans can have? I mean, abroad, I don't know if they give cards. I mean, like in Makati, they do. Okay, in Makati, there's a card. So yes. There's this first date, that's the second. So I still kept that card, right? But then I was thinking, you're right. What if you fake it? Yep. You know, I mean, you know, yun ang mga tanong, no? How do you do it then?
Yeah. So that's what we want the small group to report to us, no? What sort of authentication do we need to see? No, because you're right. Different states, for instance, in the United States, different states have different cards. Just like us here sa LGUs natin, different LGUs have different forma ng card at itsura ng card. No? In the same manner sa states, ganun din. And it's sometimes they say it's easy to fake, right? So yun, we just need to finalize that process. I mean, it's something that initially will be something that we would give us confidence, but that's not to say that yun na yung final thing. No, we just have to have one, and then we just continue to develop it even more. Para lang ano? Para lang makapag-umpisa lang.
Okay. And is there a specific policy on quarantining? I'll give you classic examples. Okay, two issues. One is a balikbayan. So they all went to the States. Three of them flew back, same flight. And mother and daughter were even asked to get a two-bedroom suite, considering they were in the States together. They were on the plane together. Mag-ina to, ha? And in the hotel, pinakunan pa sila ng two-bedroom suite, which I'm presuming they said it was policy, but of course they started, you have issues on expenses, right? If that's one, mag-ina na yun, ha? So you're assuming in the States, they lived in one house. On the plane, they sat together. And pagdating for quarantine, instead of, let's say, just one big bedroom with two beds, it's a two-bedroom suite ang requirement, or two rooms, okay? So you wonder, racket ba to? That's one. Number two, they were fully vaccinated in the U.S., but testing is on the seventh day. On the seventh day, they said the results will come out on the eighth or ninth day. More expenses in hotel stay, and they'll be released on the 10th day. So, Secretary, let's be honest. It's ridiculous already. You get the point? It's like they're already wondering, what is this? Is it for me to spend more money in this hotel?
Okay, yung 10-day rule, yung 10-day rule is based on what the experts have shared with us, no?
Na yeah, but they can, if they test negative, they can quarantine at home.
Yes. So the 10-day rule...
Negative na eh.
No, the 10-day rule is something that the experts have said na would... This is the, kumbaga, pinakasagad na araw na where in case infect yung passenger kahit sa aeroplano, pag landing niya, you give them 10 days, no? 10 days para after the 10th day, he is almost already the least infectious, okay?
No, if you get a test on the 7th day and you're negative, then you're negative.
Yes.
If you're positive, then a 10-day rule doesn't even count. No, you need to be confined. You get the point?
I understand what you're saying, no? But so the 10-day rule is something that the experts really say that will really give us the confidence. Number one, remember that 10-day rule worked with the Delta variant. The game has changed right now across the world because of that Delta variant, the one that was first detected in India. So kailangan natin isipin na ito yung parang bagong laban natin. Something that we really have to start worrying about is the Delta variant. Why? Because if the Alpha variant is 60% more transmissible, the Delta variant is 60% more transmissible than the Alpha variant. So, kumbaga, it's twice, right? Twice to worry about, no? Two times more to worry about is this Delta variant. Number two, The Delta variant that was discovered, that was first detected in India, you have longer hospitalization if you catch the Delta variant. Number three, the Delta variant hits even younger populations. In terms of sickness, gravity of sickness, symptoms, and even hospitalization. Whereas before, so original variant, if a younger person gets hit, it's usually asymptomatic or very mild, no need for hospitalization. But the experience of Delta variant, even the younger ones get hospitalized.
Yeah.
So that's dangerous. So ang experience natin, we've had 13 Delta variants come into the country. And because of the 10-day quarantine rule, then when they came out, they were not infectious anymore. So that's the reason why we're sticking with the 10-day rule. Okay, so if you do the swabbing, alam naman po natin yung swabbing here because many people are getting swabs.
Yes.
Realistically, it will really take you, 24 to 48 hours, right? 24 to 48 hours before you get the results. That's really the reality here. No, we want it to be faster, but our labs are swamped, and that's just the reality. So they put it in the seventh day na yung swab mo, prior to give chance na 24 to 48 hours. So presumably you'll get your results realistically on your ninth day, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you put a little bit of, an additional 1 day there for you to complete the 10th day. We could do the swab on the 8th day, but again, wala pa tayo masyadong confidence. Anyway, I think you want to get your swab immediately, right? So the 7th day yung pinaka-realistic. That's the reason for the 7-day, 10-day
okay.
Protocol.
All right. But like, for example, in the United Kingdom, and that's what I wanted to ask you, because in the Philippines, it seems whether you're vaccinated, not vaccinated, any country you've come from, it's the same, right? So it's quite expensive because 10 days in a hotel is not a joke. Plus ordering food. If you're an OFW, of course, the government will be paying for it, but it's also not a joke. Huh? So in the UK, for example, there's a difference of lists. There's the amber list, a green list, a red list. So they identify countries. In other words, if the country is in an amber list, day two, you take a COVID test. Then another day, you take a COVID test. But this is the difference. When you arrive, you go straight home to that place you're going to. You don't stay in, let's say, in a hotel unnecessarily for 10 days if you can quarantine at home. So this is the Cebu argument, yeah. Secretary, right? So yeah. Cebu was technically patterning the UK. We're in ang Cebu upon arrival. They did one test.
Yeah.
And then they would do another test on the 5th or 6th day, but at home. So pag negative ka upon arrival, you go straight home, you quarantine at home, you don't have to spend extra. So that's what I was wondering. How long is this overspending of people going to stay if they can be trusted to quarantine at home and get tested by the LGU or on the 5th or 6th day? So the UK is doing that. You don't literally have to stay in a hotel if you test negative on day 2 and then quarantine at home. So it depends kasi may listing eh. If it's a country where COVID is minimal, they're more lenient. Or if you've been vaccinated, meron silang differing classifications.
Yes, that's also being explored by the small group. Yung UK model or the ones that you have classifications of different countries,
yeah.
Depending on the how infected or how much of their population is infected, kung mataas bang COVID doon or hindi. So yes, that's number one being considered. I also like to point out, no, since nabanggit na rin yung UK, different countries have different ways of doing it. Korea only accepts Korean travelers.
Okay.
Hong Kong has a 21-day quarantine rule.
Thailand, for everyone to set?
Yeah, that's the report to us. Thailand, has 14 days even if vaccinated. Singapore has also a 21-day rule. So different countries have different quarantine rules.
Oh.
Depending on the confidence.
But they are they allowed kasi to quarantine at home? That's the question. That makes the difference. Even if it's 14 to 21 days, but how do they do it? If you test negative, are you at home?
Alam ko may mga quarantine facilities din sila eh. So okay. Yung sa Cebu, just to clarify.
What will happen to Cebu Secretary?
No, we've already had this discussion and the president already made a decision. So Cebu has to follow. Cebu has to follow the same protocols. Again, it's not to make things difficult, really. It's just to protect us against the variants of concern about, well, to protect us against COVID coming in, to protect us against the variants of concern, but more specifically and more, you know, we're more worried really about the Delta variant. So yung Cebu, alam ko, they tried doing that because of the limit of their hotel rooms as well. So limitado rin yung hotel rooms ng Cebu. They don't have as many hotel rooms as we have in NCR. So they really have, there's two options there. You put a cap on the number of passengers you can accept if you follow the 10-day rule, or if you want to take out the cap, that's what they did. They tried to do a test upon swab, no need to stay in a hotel because they can then accept more
travelers. Oh, you agree.
Which is good for the economy, yes, but isang lusutan lang tayo ng isang Indian or Delta variant. Yun yung worry natin eh. Malusutan lang tayo ng isa, it will change the rules and the game in that locality and start spreading. And we don't want what happened in India to happen to us.
Mm.
Because that Indian variant, you know, it's already in 80 countries.
Mm.
80 countries already have it. Of course, we're included in that list.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Wala tayong community transmission.
Mm-mm.
Yun ang babantayan natin. The moment magka-community transmission tayo ng Indian variant, that's gonna be really, really worrisome for all of us. That's
okay.
Gonna be really troublesome.
Okay, Secretary, sabi ng Cebu, they will follow the IATF order with innovations. Are they allowed to innovate? You know, ano tong with innovations?
We have to see the innovations. Alam ko, the IATF will be sending a team to Cebu, I think next week.
Okay.
This week or next week. For a dialogue to happen, no, a closed door dialogue to happen, and then let's see. Maybe it was said in that context. Baka that's when they will show us the innovations, and we'll take a look at it and we'll discuss it. And see.
Here's another good question. Ang dami kong tanong sa inyo, Secretary, ha? Okay, we're gonna go to a quick break, but here's another one. Okay, we'll talk about the Israeli experts that have arrived, so you can give us an overview on what they plan to do, what do we plan to learn from them. Another thing is also the face shield policy. Ano ba talaga? Eto tayo, we're all confused. You have some people arguing na, no, you have to wear it. You don't have to wear it. Let's settle that today. I'll give you another one. If you have been fully vaccinated in your LGU, for example, Makati, we want to reopen tourism, don't we?
Mm-mm.
Fully vaccinated ka na, double dose. You're gonna ride a plane. Eto pa, eto na naman tayo. They're requiring an RT-PCR. I've had some friends who've asked me, Karen, can you ask the secretary, if you've been fully vaccinated, bakit di na lang swab antigen? Diba? Mas mura yun. They're all requiring RT-PCR pag flight. So you're talking about 3, 5, 4, 5. So the question is, shouldn't fully vaccinated individuals nga be given an incentive of mobility? That, you know, nagpabakuna ka, di, you're not spending as much, pwede ka gumalaw. Hindi ko sinasabing ano, ha, be lax, ha? Hindi po yun. O, yun, Secretary, is that being discussed also?
Yes. It is.
Oh, good. Uh-oh.
Okay. You wanted to ask? I thought you were
going
to
answer that. Answer that.
Yes. So lahat yan, no? Both for international travelers or even domestic. So that's also being discussed. No, what are the advantages or what sort of
incentives? Yeah, that's the way.
I guess incentives or new
mobility changes.
For fully vaccinated. No, which we continuously monitor what other countries are doing as well. No, because syempre, in those areas, mas wide yung population na vaccinate na. Like, for instance, the US CDC. That's something that we sometimes benchmark upon or we try to monitor what they're doing in terms of domestic flights. No,
And what are they doing? I'm curious. Do they require RT-PCR?
I don't know.
No, right now.
Alam ko pabago-bago, like... if I'm not mistaken, no, like the wearing of like ang bench tinitingnan namin diyan NBA, di ba?
Looking at the NBA actually the game, the stadium.
The stadiums, and there're just so many people there, and you kind of presume na are they all vaccinated? They're not, some of them are wearing masks. Is it voluntary now to wear mask if you're vaccinated? No, it's not, no longer imposed. So these are the things that we are observing, we're looking out. And by the way, yung sa US also, they also reported na meron din silang Delta variant. So that's also something that we're closely monitoring, no? Whether or not what they're practicing in the United States is also, against the Delta variant. Is it
that? Yeah. A friend of mine told me just for conversation before that in the NBA, if you're fully vaccinated, to watch it, I could be corrected, guys. You can message Secretary and I right now. Is if you're fully vaccinated, you're in one area. Then that's what I heard. If you're not vaccinated, like you refuse, then you're all just in one area. Parang ganon.
Yeah. Some of our private sector stakeholders have also given us those suggestions or recommendations. No, like for instance, in restaurants.
Yeah.
What if ganito? No. So they've also come up with certain recommendations which we continue to study. No. In one section, mga vaccinated. In another section. Not completely vaccinated, diba? And what sort of proof do you want to see?
Yeah, what proof?
Like in a restaurant, what kind of proof? I mean, is it enough that you show your vaccination card that given to you by the LGU showing that you've been fully vaccinated? So these are things that will continue to be discussed, especially in light of us coming out with a common vaccination ID, digital ID with a QR code, which the ICT is working on. Kasi understandably,
pero ang tagal na nito, hindi nga natin na digital yung contact tracing nationally. I mean, seriously.
Well,
isn't this a bit late?
No. The digital vaccination ID card will be very important. In fact, we continue to make representations with WHO to have a common digital card for all countries, right?
Okay.
For all countries, para for all travelers, it will be easier, more convenient. So many countries have in fact been calling out the WHO to get into that and to come up with the procedure, the protocol, the simple mechanics for us to have a common vaccine passport, if you want to call it.
Yes.
Na digital na QR code based na rin.